And the voice says, I can hear, but I'll swap with someone who can't if you want. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful to see you for our spring concert. Have you noticed the sand in the air at the moment? I just walked to the music block back and I've got a sore throat. I think it might be the Saharan sand that's getting blown over. But I have to tell you, the driver of EA12FNL, a white Vauxhall Corsa, you might find the whole desert in your car because apparently you've left your window wide open. So let's all watch for who wanders out after this next concert. Might be you want to close your window. Welcome, we hope you have a good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the Melbourne Choir.
Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have our chamber orchestra next, and as they're just coming on and getting set up, we actually take a little bit of time in the morning of a concert like this to rehearse some of the movement and make sure that you're not kept waiting, because there's nothing worse than that. And one of the things we can talk about as well is stage presence when we can, and talk about how you acknowledge your audience. And I think it's a young person thing, but sometimes, you know, when young people concentrate really hard, they do feel a bit unhappy. And it's not that they're not into it, it's just how they are. It's just how they are. So what it'd be nice to do is, while waiting, maybe, if you're near a young person who's performing tonight, they're going to give you a beaming smile right now. Every single one of them is going to smile at you. Nearly every single one. So that's the best we're going to get, I think. I think we're ready. So here are two baroque dances from the Chamber Orchestra. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now going to have a group who are rehearsing it from work they've done in the curriculum. We have two of these groups and I'll go from Mrs. Hall's Year 10 GCSE class. So these guys are learning to put the music together themselves in a few brief lessons and then casually perform it in front of 350 people at the Easter concert. So I'm sure they're going to be fine. They're going to play in a change to the advertised programme. Dexter's theme from a show called Dexter that apparently you know about. I've never heard of it, which puts me even further apart than I've ever been. So here's Dexter's theme from Year 10 on Sunday.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, can I just ask, is everyone in having a time tonight who's made the effort to come out? Is it good? That's reassuring. Always a worry, you never know. But that's great, thank you. We're going to perform for you now the final piece in this half from the concert band. You'd have noticed earlier on in the male voice choir, the first piece was conducted by Jonathan Moreau, one of our outgoing Year 13 students. And taking the baton for the concert band, the first time anyone but me has ever conducted the concert band, in the 10 years the concert band has been running, but I wasn't going to tell you that. I don't know why I told him now. I don't know. This is Elliot's last concert with us in his school career. There's a few others, we're going to mention them later, I'm sure. And you'll see more students taking the lead in the second half. I remember the thrill when I was a young man in conducting a big band for the first time and how terrifying it was, but also how thrilling. Elliot, we've picked quite a hard piece, haven't we, for your first go. So it's quite challenging. Elliot's done ever so well. So could you give him maybe in this challenging piece some encouragement? Just a minute when I'm done. And after that, if we let the students depart first down to the Frampton Theatre, then the aisles will be free for yourselves to share some refreshments in the canteen. Okay, would you welcome Elliot? Give yourself a round of applause. Too much music in a turn to fit into a concert. And I apologise to these guys, but I I have given some students the opportunity to play in the interval for anyone. There's always a few that don't like the crowds and stay here. People want them back in at different times. So there will be music going on in the hall by some very fine young ensembles getting their first chance ever on a big stage. Don't feel you have to stay at all. They know there's only going to be a few people. I think they quite like that. There's only going to be a few people to start with. And then if they're playing when you come in, do come in. Don't worry about filing in whilst they're visiting. So, okay, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Your freshmen's await for you.
Thank you. sunshine when she's gone. It's not home when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away.
perfect in order in a black hole. I'm about as pretty as a fast hole. Bloody Mary back in a Tabasco. Remember when you used to be a rascal? Oh, the boy that I had. The best you ever had. The best you ever had. And it's just a memory and old dreams. To stop the daisy. To stop the daisy. I love when you dream. There are. Flicking through a little cookie tins. Remember when I walked through a
on? Sorry, I could never tell on this side. Is it on? So this is our big band, ladies and gentlemen. You find a flyer on your chair, this is there. Tasty little flyer about a jazz night coming up. Do have read. It's the band that teaches there with our string orchestra. We form a jazz, SHSB jazz orchestra on that night. Do have a look. I have to conduct this one, so I'll come down here. Better turn my mic on as well. Sorry, here we go. Here's the next one. Tastes like chicken.
Thank you. We're up all night to get lucky. We're up all night to
This is the orchestra. Come on, ladies and gentlemen. We have lots, 40, 50, year sevens. Lots. There's many lots at the side. And I think they do this so well because they're concentrated all morning, which they never do in school. They're concentrated all morning by a person, and they're here inside. They've heard it all, well, a lot of it this morning, and they're here enjoying it, and they're focused. I think year seven just deserve a round of applause if you're happy. And well. Thank you. Did you get one mark? It was all the way through that one. Did you hear me breathing at all? Did you hear me having under my breath? No, I'm not. Sorry if you did. Now we have a performance by Adam Woodcock. Every year in school we have a house music competition, which only started, I think, in the last 6 or 7 years, where every house, we know about the house system, don't we, basically? Every house has to produce a musician who plays the guitar, a musician who plays a woodwind instrument, a brass instrument, a piano, percussion, singing. I've probably left someone out, I feel bad. But seven categories, and they have to produce a musician for years 7 to 9, years 10 and 11, and then the sixth form. So on a particular day, we have up to 16 people competing to win their age group, and then one winner of those 16 becomes the best, whatever it's pianist for that day, or the best brass player, and they go through to a final where they compete against the best from every other day. So we have 7 performances in the final, and from those 7 performances we have a judge or judges to choose one overall winner, who then gets a special trophy and is the musician of the year. And I'm very pleased to say that this year it was Adam Woodcock, our lead kit drummer, who plays in our big band. I think the first kit drummer ever to win it in the history of the competition, 7 or 8 years, so that's excellent, playing a jazz piece, which we're going to hear now, because I give the winner the chance to play a solo in the spring concert. So I hope that's okay. We don't often have solos, but I think Adam's earned the right by beating all those other people and winning the trophy to perform for you now. I'm sure you're going to hear from the sophistication and the stuff that he's playing exactly why he won that competition. So do welcome Adam as he performs for you.
Thank you. is an absolute delight to be here this evening with a complete sell-out audience. I am aware that that means that there are people who aren't here tonight who wanted to have tickets. And I know that you'll join me in letting them know what a great show they've missed. I'm sorry that not everybody was able to get tickets. I'm sorry also that one or two of you had difficulties getting into the car park. I'm sure you understand why, and I think you agree with me that it's been worth every moment. Can we say thank you very much for all your support? And the performers wouldn't have a concert if it wasn't for you lot. So, would you all join me and say thank you very much to your audience tonight? And it is very often your initiative that pushes a son or a daughter just to start doing something. And tonight has been a fantastic festival, not only of excellence at the upper end, and I do mean excellence, you have seen some very special performances tonight. But also, it's a celebration of progression. One of the Year 7s who is up here tonight will be doing a solo as House Musician of the Year, School Musician of the Year, this time in 6 years' time. It's going to be my keynote. And we've seen the progression working through. And in particular, there are a number of students for whom this is their last major public concert with the school. And I would ask every one of those students from Year 13, I realise that some of you are already there, but I would ask those in Year 13 to stand to receive our particular thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to all our wonderful students. Concert band at the end, but also joined by our chamber orchestra, Skyfall, James Bond, dedicated to anyone that looks good in a three-piece.
Thank you.
very much, and do have a safe journey home. Thank you.